Blackstone Audio presents The Politically Incorrect Guide to Climate Change by Marc Morano. This book is read by John McLain. This book is dedicated to the pioneers who challenged the man-made global warming narrative years before it displaced earlier environmental scares such as the Amazon rainforest deforestation movement. Pioneers like atmospheric physicist Fred Singer, MIT's Richard Lindzen, Bill Gray, Pat Michaels, and so many other scientists were first to take on the government, media, academia, UN complex. And one political leader stands out, Oklahoma Senator James Inhofe, author of The Greatest Hoax. Inhofe stood up fearlessly to the alleged consensus and the political solutions being promoted to solve climate change. Senator Inhofe, my former boss, stared down the media and political establishment when other Republicans were intimidated into silence. Others instrumental in paving the way for this book were Ralph Hostetter and my former bosses Rush Limbaugh, Paul Weyrich, and Brent Bozell, and his Media Research Center team, who took on the media and political classes and documented and deflated their claims. In this book, I have endeavored to follow in these pioneers' wake and provide the public with a full history and exposé of just what exactly lies behind the man-made climate change curtain. Foreword by John Coleman. Don't worry about climate change, says Marc Morano. There is no significant man-made global warming. Are you kidding me? We all know that the ice caps are melting. The oceans are about to flood our cities, and more superstorms are happening. And the experts are certain that mankind's use of fossil fuels is causing it all. We have all the facts, right? The truth is that there is a debate about climate change, but it has been very one-sided. With the U.S. government, all the scientific organizations, Al Gore, the science guy, Hollywood, the Democratic Party, and the United Nations all behind the bad news that our use of fossil fuels is destroying the climate of Earth. Anyone on the other side of the debate finds themselves behind the eight ball. Peeking out from behind the eight ball is Marc Morano. In this great book, he begins his comprehensive review of the debate about global warming by chatting about the history of climate scares in centuries past, and goes on to decisively debunk the current climate scare. By the time he's done, you will realize you've been hoaxed. Climate change has become a scam. As the founder of the Weather Channel and a six-decade veteran TV news weatherman, I know a great deal about this topic. We meteorologists are well aware of how limited our ability is to predict the weather. Our predictions become dramatically less reliable as they extend out into the future. When we try to predict just a few weeks into the future, our predictions become increasingly inaccurate. Yet the climate change establishment that now dominates the UN bureaucracy and our own government science establishment claim that they can predict the temperature of the Earth decades into the future. Their global warming scare is not driven by science. It is now being driven by politics. So today, anybody who defies the prevailing climate change scare puts his career and his reputation into extreme danger. That is where we find Mark. He is living life behind the eight ball. He's been there for decades. But whatever you may hear from his enemies in the climate change establishment, he is no crazy denier or shill for big oil. The explanation is simple. He is so certain of his data that he is quite comfy there behind the eight ball. When you really study the issue, you realize that Marc Morano is absolutely right. And it turns out he is not alone there behind the eight ball. He has developed relationships with hundreds of brilliant scientists and other experts who are willing to testify, along with Mark, that in fact, there is no significant man-made global warming. This book is exactly what parents need to counter the indoctrination our children are now being subjected to. Starting at a very young age and continuing through their teenage years, American school children are being constantly bombarded with climate change propaganda. This is science gone bad. it has become political, and climate science has been hijacked by the extreme fringe of the environmental movement. The truth is that while climate is naturally changing, as it always has, no crisis is occurring and there is no reason to fear any in the future. This book uses over 1,200 footnotes to bolster its compelling, scientific, and logical demonstration that Al Gore and the United Nations are dead wrong on climate fears. And maybe even more important, this book uses the climate change establishment's own words to refute their silly claims. Listen to this book, and Mark will become your hero. Give it to your friends to listen to. Maybe in the end, there will be enough of us who no longer believe the climate change hoax that he, and those of us who know he is right, can get out from behind the eight ball and enjoy life. Listen on, my friend. Listen on. Chapter 1. The Education of a Climate Denier. Did you know? The purported 97% scientific consensus on climate change was pulled from thin air. Over 750 skeptical scientists were featured in a Senate Environment and Public Works Committee report. A former UN IPCC official called global warming my religion. I am not a scientist, though I do occasionally play one on TV. Well, actually, I debate scientists there, regularly appearing on television to expose the unscientific claims about catastrophic, man-made climate change. My degree is in political science, which happens to be the ideal background for examining man-made global warming claims, which, as ample evidence set forth in this book will demonstrate, are driven more by politics than by science. I have spent the last 25 years in a range of disciplines, including as a working journalist, documentary maker, radio talk show host, author, and national television correspondent. I've been passionate about environmental issues since I began my career in 1991. I produced a documentary on the myths surrounding the Amazon rainforest in 2000 and have reported extensively, at one time holding both White House and Capitol Hill press credentials, on environmental and energy issues such as deforestation, endangered species, pollution, and climate change. I co-wrote, hosted, and co-produced the 2016 global warming documentary, Climate Hustle, which was featured in over 400 theaters in the United States. The film featured current and former UN scientists who have turned against the UN and prominent politically left-wing scientists who have reversed their views and now reject claims of a man-made climate crisis. I am a climate skeptic, a doubter, a dissenter, and have been smeared as a denier. But I am not alone in my skepticism. I work regularly with a huge network of internationally renowned scientists, many of them formerly of the United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, UNIPCC. Less charitable names have been used to describe us. The vicious name-calling starts with the climate denier epithet, that is meant to evoke comparisons to Holocaust deniers. But it doesn't stop there. Rave reviews. In 2015, I appeared, as the villain, in the Sony Pictures climate activist documentary, Merchants of Doubt. The reviews were glowing, as in, I was torched. Reviewers called me terrifyingly impressive, sadistic, and the documentary's most engaging character. I was a magnificent anti-hero, a cheery, chatty prevaricator, slick and scary, a loathsome mercenary, a sleazy spin doctor, and a grinning skull nihilist. The Daily Cause said I was evil personified. Rolling Stone magazine named me one of the planet's 17 climate killers in its December 2009 cover story. The magazine described me as the Matt Drudge of climate denial and a central cell of the climate denial machine. In 2009, Newsweek magazine declared that Morano undeniably is quickly becoming king of the skeptics. Professor Andrew Watson called me an asshole on a live BBC TV broadcast about ClimateGate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.